Colleen Springer's breast cancer journey started back in August when she went to the doctor for a routine mammogram appointment in Gregory.
Unfortunately, they had to call me back in, and my first initial thought was, I don't have time for this. Are you serious? But I went back in because they did find a spot. I came to Sioux Falls and they did a biopsy here, and it did turn out to be cancer. I met with Dr. Brian after that. We went over all of our options.
Living nearly 3 hours away, Springer needed an option that best fit her lifestyle.
That diagnosis of an early breast cancer offered her some different options, which would include all included surgery, but either just taking the area of the tumor, which does come with radiation, or a full mastectomy, which is taking the whole breast. And so for her, being able to offer her an option of less driving, a more focused radiation, really made the difference in what she was able to choose for surgery.
Collaboration between Dr. Brian and radiation oncologist Dr. Murphy, it was decided Springer would benefit from intraoperative radiation therapy, or IORT, which involves a combination of surgery and radiation.
Intraoperative radiation therapy is an option where instead of all of the doses of radiation being delivered externally, and for the radiation oncologist to deliver each of those beams in separate office visits, often from 3 to 6 weeks, it can actually deliver the entire dose intraoperatively at the time of the surgery.
It's definitely case by case. Some women are candidates, some are not, and we go through that. It's definitely important to have the conversation with the doctor, you know, knowing that it may or may not be an option, but we, you know, always go through all of the options with our patients.
IORT is ideal for patients with early stage breast cancer. Springer's surgery was scheduled for October.
We're taking a device to deliver the radiation about this big, and I have to get it into your breast tissue. The first thing we do is check the lymph nodes, and that's kind of up in the armpit because we want to make sure there's no lymph node spread. The next thing that we did was actually open up and remove the tumor. I then separate the tissue around, and in order to separate that out, I want to make sure that I'm bringing together so that it can fit right under the radiation delivery column, the tissue that I want to deliver all of that dose to.
I would go up with my team, which is a physicist and a couple of radiation therapists. And at that point, I kind of take over in terms of deciding how we would want to deliver that radiation and setting that part up with Dr. Brian. And, you know, so we're collaborating in the operating room. And then I plan that with my physics team, and we deliver the treatment.
Big team for kind of really shortening up some treatment for the patient.
It was the right treatment because my cancer was grade 1, and the one-time radiation could do it. If I had to drive 5 days or if I had to do it for months, you do what you have to do to live. And I would have done that. But I'm so grateful that they could find the right treatment for me in the time frame they did.
Now she is cancer-free and recognizes the care she received made a difference in her cancer journey.
The providers here, the doctors here, they really explain things and they make you feel like you're the only patient they've ever had. I mean, seriously, they really sit down with you and explain it all to you, and they take the time with you, and that's what's very, very nice.